Today we're going out to a project out at Gippsland, Victoria. We're going to be catching up with Dale from APHI Projects on a home that's been built to passive house principles. G'day, Dale.
How are you, mate?
How are you?
Yeah, good. How are you going?
Not too bad.
Good to see ya.
What have we got here today?
CLT, Passive House Principles Building, down in Langatham.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Looks unbelievable.
Yeah, thanks, man. We're pretty happy with it. Just handed it over last week, so clients are starting to move bits and pieces in, and we're doing a few little final touches and get you to do a final pressure test and see how we went.
Fantastic. It's a great finish.
Yeah, thanks, mate. CLT throughout,
start
to finish. So one of the only building I know of in Australia at the moment that's full CLT start to finish, every element aside from the slab, basically. The CLT is obviously the big one, and it was a big one for us, a big draw card for us to be involved with the project.
Yep.
Being from Geelong, it's a fair way from home. It was awesome to have the CLT come from Binderholz in Austria.
So explain, so CLT, what does it mean? So we've got a finish?
So it's basically the internal finish is what it is.
Yep.
Like it's a European spruce,
finished
timber, and it's a solid wall, solid 96 mil wall, made up of 5 lamellar and cross-laminated. On the outer layer, that's covered with the Gutex insulation.
And it's structural, right?
Yeah, it's all structural. Yep. All elements are structural. Got a couple of glue lamb beams, like the one you can see there in the hallway ceiling. Just picking up some of the roof panels, some of the load points.
And how did you get those panels in?
All craned in.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, so some of the wall panels we did by hand because they were a bit smaller and a bit easier to manhandle.
Okay, so your wall insulation?
100 mil Gutex over the walls, timber fiberboard out of Germany as well, and it gives us a total R value of 3.8. 3.9, around there. And then obviously on top of the Gutex, we've got a weather-tight layer, building membrane, Proclimer layer, and then a batten, and then the Core 10 cladding over the top of that.
Let's have a look at this Gutex insulation.
So it's a compacted timber fibre, but it is very diffusion open, so allow any moisture that builds up in wall cavities of that to be able to pass through it. As you know, with passive house and buildings being so airtight these days, vapor permeability and issues of condensation are becoming more common. It's important that the building materials as you go to the outside of the building are more vapor permeable as you move out. This is a really good product for that, as opposed to say XPS or EPS or something like that.
Okay, so what have we got up in the roof insulation? So
the roof's basically the same build up as the walls, except it's got an extra layer of Gutex.
Yeah.
Almost doubles the R value, gives us an R value of about 6.8. The combination of the solid, there's some thermal mass obviously in the solid timber panels as well, so the combination of the thermal mass and the insulation works really well.
We might hit it with the thermal imaging camera a little bit later and see what it looks like.
Have a look what's
going
on.
See how consistent it is.
Well, it's fairly cool outside today and it's nice. And cozy in here again, isn't it?
Cozy. So it's great.
Yesterday was 37 and I think we had sort of 23, 24 degrees in here. The floor system is a combination of XPS, EPS foam. It's the MaxRaft system, so it's a proprietary system out of New Zealand.
Right.
This was actually the first building in Australia that they'd done, but they've got a bit of momentum now and doing a few other projects.
And the sides of the slab have been insulated too?
All the concrete is completely encased in XPS, So it gives it a total R value of 2.8. So that's why the slab pretty much stays between 19 and 23 degrees.
Great finish on the hallway, mate.
Thanks, mate. Cheers, The shadow lines and the concealed LEDs worked really well. So you got the European tilt turn timber windows, American oak. We're in a Bell 12.5 fire rated area out here, so we needed the American oak for the density of the timber to meet the Bell requirement.
So that's a door?
That's a door,
yeah.
Door slash window, so you have the ability to use it in the tilt position.
Wow.
So you can already feel the breeze coming through there, how much ventilation you get from having it in the tilt position.
Yeah.
That's completely secure. You can't possibly open that door from the outside because you've got to actually get it back into the turn position before it locks in.
So turn it the other way and show us how it opens.
And then it works as a door.
And then to lock it into place?
Yeah, to lock it into place, you just, same as a normal door, shut it, handles horizontal, handles vertical down.
And that presses into the seals?
Yeah, it's got locking points all the way around the door.
Yeah.
Awesome for air tightness and weather tightness as well, obviously.
Now that you've got fantastic R value on your walls, ceiling and your floor, and we've also got your air tightness, hopefully, in the right spot. What's the benefit of getting this building to that level of air tightness and insulation consistency?
It's all about the thermal comfort, John. You know, the idea with passive house is to keep 21 degrees day in, day out, year round internal temperatures, and have all the surfaces reasonably uniform throughout. By keeping the building airtight, by insulating it properly, gives you the best opportunity to do that.
Yeah.
In conjunction with that is having mechanical ventilation, because once the building becomes so airtight, as you would know, you need that mechanical ventilation to bring fresh air into the building, but at the same time retaining the energy that's already in the building and reintroducing that into the fresh air coming in.
And filtering the air,
pollen. Yeah, which is a big thing down here, because you know, there's a lot of fields, a lot of open paddocks out here that veggies are growing in, that a lot of dirt and dust has been blown out of the fields onto the house year round. You got heaps of bugs down here, mosquitoes and that.
Well, let's have a look at the heart then.
This is basically the heart of the building. You got extract air, fresh air in, exhaust extracted air from the building.
And heating and cooling?
Yeah, so we've got in this one, it's a little bit unique. We've integrated a 3.5 kilowatt Daikin split. Yesterday was 37 degrees, so they have the ability just to bring that indoor, the feed air down a little bit in temperature if they need to.
Does that control humidity as well?
Yeah, it does. Yeah. And you have the ability to have humidity dehumidification only on it as well, which is really good,
From a ventilation perspective, what are the rooms that are ventilated? What are the rooms that are exhausted? What are the rooms that are pressurized?
So naturally, all services rooms are exhausted.
Yep.
So bathrooms, laundry, kitchen, any services rooms are exhausted. And then all habitable rooms have supply air, bedrooms, living spaces. You can see here we've got an exhaust vent in this room being the laundry, and if you have a look behind you over there in the bedroom, you can see a supply air duct coming out of the ceiling there. Whilst the windows and doors work really well in the tilt position as ventilation, they're not a necessity in the building, and naturally in the winter time you don't want to open your doors and windows because you don't want to lose that heat straight out of the ventilation. So use the ventilation system to recover that heat but bring your fresh air in.
So what's the deal with this induction cooktop?
German made borer cooktop, downdrafting range hood on it. The idea is that you obviously want to limit the amount of penetrations in the building envelope. So by using an integrated downdrafting range hood with a carbon filter, we're able to limit the need for an overhead range hood, which would be naturally ducted to the outside of the building. This filters it and then just blows the air back, the exhaust air back out on the other side there, underneath the bench top.
There's very little temperature differential in this corner junction. So the insulation consistency on this build is amazing. Not even a degree temperature differential on the corner junction. In the majority of older homes with poorly installed insulation, you can have gaps around recessed lighting, around ducted heating and cooling outlets. And when you add up all of the gaps within the insulation on the wall or the ceiling, it can have a considerable impact on the overall performance of the insulation that's been installed. So in this house, the insulation is extraordinarily consistent on the junctions, with the wall systems, and obviously also with the ceiling. I noticed your downpipes, they're not really downpipes, are they?
No, the client brief here was to have no downpipes, but being such a wet area in Gippsland, we weren't really keen on the original design of box gutters and concealed downpipes.
Yeah.
We managed to work with the client to come up with the chain system, which, seems to be working really well, actually. Yeah. We were a little bit hesitant at first, but it's actually working quite good.
Fantastic. All right, so what do you reckon? You guys helped me prepare the building and tape off the supply and exhaust of the ventilation system.
Yep.
And then I'll set up my fan and we can see how airtight this bad boy is. So we've just turned off the HRV system. So Dale, you're gonna tape that up for me. That's perforated tape from Efficiency Matrix. We supply that stuff. It's quick and easy to seal up things that need to be sealed up when you're doing an air tightness test of a building.
This would be a freebie roll for us, wouldn't it?
So with 32 kilometre hour winds on all facades and the roof and the ground, which is theoretically impossible, the air changes in this building will be about 0.32 air changes, so volume of air per hour being exchanged. Even by opening up a window, this house is still more airtight than a normal home in Melbourne, Australia. So it's currently sitting on with a window open, 7.0 ACH at 50 pascals. You'd expect most homes in Australia to be between 10 and 15 ACH at 50 pascals. So it's closed, but not locked into position. Closed but not locked, not pressing against its door seal. So basically, two doors latched open but closed will fail this building. It just shows you how airtight this building is. So now I'm going to be running a passive house airtightness test. We're actually running a baseline test where we're testing or we're comparing the inside pressure of the building compared to outside. So this will give you a really good understanding of whether there's too much wind for the test to be actually done. But right now we're getting a really smooth baseline. The wind's really come down and it's just finished collecting all the data that it needs. And now we're gonna run the pressure test starting at 20 pascals. It's actually overshot the mark. So it's just gonna have to stabilize on that. In fact, I'm gonna have to reduce the airflow and plug up one of the holes, because the building is too tight to test at this range. So we're inducing a pressure of 20 pascals on this building with that sized hole. So at 20 pascals, the building is doing 0.15 ACH. 100 pascals on C1. Amazingly tight, and it's still under 0.6 at 90 pascals. We just pressure tested the house in negative pressure. And now we're going to test it in positive. Bit of pressure on this door.
There we go, John.
0.33 ACH at
really?
50.
That's awesome. So
well done, mate.
CLT's the answer, hey?
That's a great job. Makes, I don't know about it being the answer.
Makes air tightness easy, though.
It works well. It definitely works well.
All good. Thanks,
all right,
mate.
Good stuff.
Thanks for all your help.
Pleasure.